With the release of AMD's Zen 3 desktop CPUs, consumers have access to double-digit multi-core processors that are fast and powerful, and that excel at multitasking. This is perfect for today's online presence, whether you're streaming, while playing the latest AAA games, doing 3D work, or editing videos on a deadline. So we're going to show you how to squeeze the most power out of your new Ryzen CPU with a quick overclocking guide. Hi, I'm Rick, your host for today's episode, and we're going to give you some recommendations, BIOS configurations, and do some tests on the overclocking capabilities of the AMD Ryzen 9 5900X. As with all CPUs, each processor has a slightly different overclocking ability, with some performing better than others. So let's see how this one scores. So we'll be doing some baseline tests and then see how far we can push this 7-nanometer processor. The Ryzen 9 5900X is a 12-core, 24-thread CPU at 3.7 GHz stock up to 4.8 GHz boost with 64 megs of L3 cache. Supporting DDR4 up to 3200 MHz officially, which you can push with overclocking, the CPU has a 105 watt TDP, so it'll need some good cooling. Using socket AM4, the Ryzen 9 5900X connects with 24 PCIe Gen 4 lanes, and Gen 4 delivers double the speed of Gen 3. MSI's latest MEG B550 UNIFY-X uses an AM4 socket for the CPU, which is powered by dual CPU 8-pin connectors. This feeds into a direct 14+2 VRM design with 90 amp power stage, so you can reach your CPU's full potential. Dual DDR4 slots can overclock RAM to a potential 5800 MHz with compatible sets, and there's four PCIe M.2 slots. With fast 2.5 gigabit LAN and Wi-Fi 6, it also has HDMI 2.1 for CPUs with integrated graphics, and rear and internal USB Type-C ports, so it has all the speed and connectivity you'll need. Our usual disclaimer before we start, motherboards and CPUs have built-in protection to limit and even shut down before damage occurs, but we are pushing the CPU beyond its normal operation. Following our steps should be safe, but you do so at your own risk. Additionally, overclocking requires tuning the voltage for the CPU, called V-core, and although we'll adjust it by small amounts, too much V-core can possibly fry your CPU and even damage your motherboard. A 0.05 volt increase is a lot, generating more heat per core, and we've got 12 cores here. We're not out to set any records today, so you should be able to get similar results pretty safely, and let us know about your overclocking and benchmark results in the comments below. Our build is in our MPG Secura 500G case. It's got toolless dual hinge tempered glass side panels with spots up front for up to a 280mm AIO water cooler, and up top it can handle a 360mm radiator on a sliding bracket for easy installation. Running 12 cores at max, even before tuning, requires a good cooling solution, and we recommend a 360mm radiator like our Core Liquid 360R, a large all-in-one water cooler which helps dump all the heat from the AMD 5900X overclocked at full load. Powering our rig is our MPG A850GF, which has enough headroom and cables for the latest AMD or NVIDIA graphics cards. Overclocking needs a good power supply with solid 12-volt rails, two ATX 8-pin connectors, and we recommend at least a 700 to 800-watt PSU. If you're choosing components, we have an Intro to PC series, link up here, for what you need to look for and tips on choosing the latest tech. Graphics, we have an NVIDIA RTX 2080 Super installed and 16 gigs of Trident Z Royal DDR4 RAM overclockable to 3600 MHz. Super fast Windows 10 loading is thanks to the 500 gig Kingston A2000 PCIe SSD, and these M.2 drives minimize game loading times with fast file access. Before adjusting BIOS, let's start with a baseline for results so we can compare our overclocking results later. Cinebench R15 turns in a big 3566 points, while Cinebench R20 scores a whopping 8338 marks, and here, higher numbers are better. Next, we ran Blender's BMW test, completing in a quick 1 minute 58.60 seconds. Another standard test, Blender's Classroom, gave us the fastest result we've ever seen, 5 minutes 03.43, which is really amazing. Always change CPU values first, then enable XMP or manually OC your RAM when everything is stable. We often focus on all-core overclocking, and some recent CPUs also have per-core overclocking. AMD has this also, called PBO or Precision Boost Overdrive, and users may be able to tweak good results here. Anyways, let's get into some all-core overclocking. Rebooting and tapping delete to get into BIOS, we'll hit F7 to get into advanced settings. And top left, we see the defaults for the CPU and DDR4. Clicking on OC, we'll go to CPU ratio and set it to 46. It turns red, that's okay. Next, we'll go down to voltage settings and change CPU core voltage to AMD overclocking. Then, in override CPU core voltage, we'll put in 1.33 and hit enter. Hit escape to go up, and we'll go into hardware monitor. We'll set an aggressive fan profile to ramp up quickly to dump radiator heat. Here, it's connected to the system 1 header. Our front fans are 4-pin, so we're using the PWM setting with smart fan mode. If you have 3-pin fans, use DC with smart fan mode. Adjusting all values up, next we'll go to CPU 1, which we have connected to the 4-pin PWM Core Liquid 360R fans, and bump those up also. Click X to close, then F10 to save, config, and reboot. Pro tip, adjusting core voltage, use very small increments. Going from 1.32 to 1.35 volts is a big jump, and more voltage equals more heat from each core of this 12-core CPU. We set an aggressive fan profile for the radiator, as high temps can have a runaway effect, and benchmarks can start crashing around 95°C. As fans spin faster and temps stop climbing and level off, having the CPU overclocked at full load around 90°C should be fine. So with an all-core boost, we're sitting at 4.6 GHz, and into Cinebench R15, we're up 319 points to 3885. Next in R20, there's a 669-point gain as we get over 9000 with a score of 9007. The Blender BMW run shaves off almost 8 seconds, coming in at 1 minute 50.92 seconds. Finally, Blender Classroom is 21 seconds faster at 4 minutes 41.72 seconds, and this is the first sub-5-minute time I've seen. Very impressive. Now we have a stable CPU overclock, let's turn on the DDR4 built-in overclock by enabling XMP. In DRAM setting, we'll change the AXMP setting to Profile 1, raising our RAM to 3600 MHz. And hit F10 and click Yes to save your settings. If you're buying DDR4 RAM, there's a slightly bigger performance gain from 2666 to 3200 MHz than from 3200 to 3600, but 3600 seems to be the sweet spot for Ryzen Zen 3 CPUs. Between 2666 and 3600 speeds, it's possible to see up to a 5 to 10% improvement in Blender, though not every program will show benefits. However, 2666 MHz RAM seems to impact 1% low frame rates in gaming, so choose at least 3200 if you can. Testing with XMP enabled actually resulted in benchmarks coming back within 1% of the results we just obtained, which is within margin of error. Our 5900X was stable at 4.6 GHz, but some chips can reach 4.7, though for everyday usage, we'd recommend to back it down 100 to 200 MHz for better stability and temperatures. For further tweaking, you can adjust CPU core voltage, and AMD's 5900X has a good performance spot between 1.32 and 1.35 volts. Frequency, voltage, and temperature all interact with each other when overclocking, and adjusting one affects the other two. So, boosting frequency makes more heat and will require more power. Undervolting can reduce temperatures and create extra headroom, and this is how PBO works. However, it can affect performance and stability negatively. Blender Classroom is great for stability testing. Run a couple of tests to check the stability of your overclocking efforts. Prime95, while being a useful metric and driving your CPU to the absolute limit, uses AVX instructions which aren't used in any gaming or normal productivity. If you set your overclock based on Prime95's AVX testing, you could be leaving performance on the table, so be aware. If you're overclocking, let us know what kind of results you got with your setup down in the comments. If this guide helped you or you learned something, be sure to hit that thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to MSI Gaming for the latest news. Thanks for joining us today and happy overclocking. See you all in the next episode.